वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। ब्रांड अवेयरनेस इज द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट कंज्यूमर्स आर फैमिलियर अबाउट द लाइफ एंड अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट। इट इज द डिग्री टू विच कंज्यूमर्स प्रिसाइसली एसोसिएटेड द ब्रांड विद द स्पेसिफिक प्रोडक्ट। इट इज मेजर्ड एज द रेशियो ऑफ नीच मार्केट दैट हैज फॉर्मर नॉलेज ऑफ ब्रांड। ब्रांड अवेयरनेस इंक्लूड both brand recognition as well as brand recall. Brand recognition is the ability of consumer to recognize prior knowledge of brand when they are asked question about that brand or when they are shown that specific brand. The consumers can clearly differentiate the brand as having been earlier noticed or heard. While brand recall is the potential of customer to recover a brand from his memory when it's given the product class or category. Needs satisfied by that category on buying scenario as a signal. In other words, it refers that consumer should correctly recover that brand from the memory when given a clue, or he can recall the specific brand when the product category is mentioned. The brand awareness is improved to the extent to which brand names are selected, and that is simple and easy to pronounce and spell, known and expressive, unique as well as distinct. For instance, Coca-Cola has came to be known as Coke. It has its distinct identity. Maggie has a distinct identity as noodles brand. There are two types of brand awareness. Aided awareness means that on mentioning the product category, it's a one type of brand awareness. The customer recognizes your brand from the list of brand shown. Top of mind awareness, immediate brand recall. This means that on mentioning the product category, the first brand that customer recall from his mind is your brand. The relative importance of brand recall and brand recognition will rely on the degree to which consumers make product related decision with the brand present or not. For instance, in a store, brand recognition is more crucial than the brand will be physically present. In a scenario where brand are not physically present, brand recall is more significant. Building brand awareness is essential for building brand equity. It includes use of various renowned channel of promotion such as advertising, word of mouth publicity, social media blogs, sponsorships, launching events, etc. To create brand awareness, it is important to create reliable brand image, slogans and taglines. The brand messages to be communicated should also be consistent. Strong brand awareness leads to high sales and high market share. Brand awareness can be regarded as a means through which consumer become acquainted and familiar with a brand and recognize that brand. The brand equity is also defined as a value and strength to that brand and decides its worth, its value, whereas customer equity is defined in terms of lifetime value of all customers. Brand equity and customer equity have two things in common. First one is both trust on significance of customer loyalty to the brand, and the second one is both emphasized upon the face that value is created by having as many customers as possible, paying as high price as possible. But conceptually, both brand equity and customer equity differ. While customer equity puts too much emphasis on lower line financial value got from the customers, brand equity attempt to put more emphasis on strategic issues in managing brands. Customer equity is less narrow alternative. It can overlook a brand optional value and their capacity affect revenues and cost beyond the present marketing environment. Just as customer equity can persist without brand equity may also exist without customer equity. For instances, I may have a positive attitude towards brand. For example, McDonald's, KFC, but I may only purchase from McDonald's brand consistently, obviously. To conclude, we can say brands do not exist without consumer, and consumer do not exist without brands either. Brands serve as a temptation that utilize other intermediaries to lure the customers from whom value is extracted. Customers serve as a profit medium for brand to encash their brand value. Both the concepts are highly correlated. The brand extension is a matter of maybe success or failure. The brand management has become quite a challenge for brand managers as well as the organization today. Intense competition and the decreasing product life of a brand add further dimension to the brand management problem. Brand managers, by and large, offer brand extension nowadays. You can check any shelf in the supermarket and you will see variant of the same brand occupying the shelf space. It is true in cases we use soft drink brand leader like Coke to a cream or shampoo. Brand managers are always under pressure to grow the market share and increase the revenue. Under constant pressure and intense competition, they find it easier to bring out brand extension in order to provide continual changes and increased value perception to the consumers. Brand extension also helps them to capture the niche segment in the market that have not been covered in the parent brand. On the part of the management, the brand extension proved help in maximizing the capacity utilization and stretching resources to the maximum. But the fact is that bothers every brand manager is whether such brand extension good for the parent brand or whether it is mistake that one is committing in the long run. There is no straight answer to the question. In some cases, brand like GE, Procter & Gamble, Spencer's, etc. have been hugely successful in making into a new business using the parent brand and stitching the brand. Brand extension too have worked well for brand like Nivea, Dove, L'Oreal Paris, etc. In many cases, the brand extension and stitching exercise have failed too. There is definitely a case for brand extension in the market for various reasons. There is nothing wrong in the firm exploiting the brand image or brand value when they have strived to build a parent brand over a period of time. Economically too, it makes sense for the company to resort the brand extension, which is far cheaper than introducing and promoting a new brand. If successful, brand extension can help strengthen the parent brand as well as capture the niche market segment, no doubt. However, the thinking behind the brand extension and brand strategies, what make the brand extension failure or a success. In case of the brand extension in plan to revive the short-term revenue, it may not withstand with the test of times. The danger of brand extension is something that should be accounted for before jumping to brand extension. The failure of brand extension can affect the perception of the consumers with regard to the parent brand and damage the brand value. In some cases, the brand extension may not generate new revenue, but eat into the parent's brand market share itself. That's all for now. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Have a nice day.